front door. If that airplane is failing and the ship it just ain't sailing, I'll buy a ticket, write the best song, New Orleans. I'll buy a ticket, write the best song in New Orleans. I'll buy a ticket, write the best song in New Orleans.
New Country 1029 WGO. All your favorite new country music, plus fast and frequent news and weather updates.
You name the babies and I name the dogs.
All on a local station committed to doing radio the right way.
Hey, you broke up with me.
This is New Country 1029.
So move on up the FM dial. Make the switch to New Country 1029 WGO.
Minot State's small enough that you get to experience a lot of good things. You get into radio right away, TV right away, work as a director or a producer or a talent on the show. It's really fun to be involved doing all those things. We've got the new technical equipment. Everything you work with here, for the most part, is going to be out there in the real world. Neil Roberts is a great mentor. He has been seasoned in TV and radio and able to bring that experience to the classroom, and he's personable. He has a passion for it and he wants everyone else to share that passion as well. I'm the director and producer of Inside Out. I work with a lot of different people and make sure that everyone's satisfied and everybody's working together to make communication what it is. Over this semester, everybody's worked together and found this rhythm with each other, and it all just comes together and makes a really nice finished product.
Tonight's special guests, Ryan Wagner and Sarah Madalin. And now, your host, Jake Thrailkill.
Good evening, Minot. Welcome to the second episode of your late show, Good Night, Minot. We never imagined that this little show of ours would be so popular. Actually, for the first time in my life, I'm starting to feel like somebody likes me.
Aw, we love you, Jake.
Yeah. Did somebody hear something?
Love you.
Anyways, thanks for being here tonight. It means the world to the team and me, and we couldn't do it without you. Tonight's monologue is brought to you by Atypical Brewery and Barrel Works, and I'd like to personally thank Nick for that right now, since he's representing them. Got an offer.
You want his beer, baby?
Well, since the last time we met here at the Arlene, winter has officially arrived. Now, most people need a calendar to tell when winter arrives, but we here in North Dakota know that winter has officially arrived when Josh Walski puts away the visor. Winter in North Dakota is so cold. I mean, it is so cold, right? It is so cold that the hipsters at NOLA's are growing beers for non-ironic purposes. It's so cold that the other day I saw city manager Tom Barry walking around with his hands in his own pockets. But seriously, did everybody have a good Christmas? Yeah. I know I did. The gifts were just rolling in. So much so that, you know, when you're unwrapping the gifts in the living room and you get wrapping paper for days and for days and for days? Well, I had so much paper that it actually filled two trash bags.
So, oh, your mommy must give you lots of presents still.
Well, yeah, she is here, so she would agree with that.
Thanks,
yeah.
Mom. Mm-hmm.
But not nearly as many as I got from your mom.
She is generous. Yeah. She's generous.
And everybody, it's Miles' mom's birthday today, so I wanted to give her that shout out. But I don't know who's wasted more paper lately. Me on all the gifts that I received, or Miles here handing out his number to girls on napkins at Ebenezer's.
Hey, the pile of napkins I get is way bigger than the ones I give out.
Well, considering the size of a mess that you are, it'd take a lot of napkins to clean up that spill.
Yeah, thanks for helping me with that one.
Yep. And did you hear that Walmart had to recall a bunch of their sweaters? Yeah, apparently, the sweater they had showed an image of Santa what looked like doing lines of cocaine. And, well, after that was discovered, a spokesman from Walmart reached out to the people of Walmart to let him know that they actually thought it was meth. But it's not all lost, because Walmart was actually able to pack up all of those sweaters and put them on a truck to go to South Dakota. They're on it.
Thank God.
So New Year's Eve is coming up in a few days, and I would just like to thank my date in advance, because I know she's gonna... That's a good joke. Because she... because she is going to spend a lot of time picking out the perfect dress to wear, and I'm probably just going to throw up on it sometime after midnight anyways. So has anybody out here made any New Year's resolutions?
Nobody? You all are perfect?
That's the Minot I know. No change.
The late night audience is not into changing.
Right,
things.
No. We're pretty content with who we are. Right. So what about you, Miles? Have you made any resolutions?
I have, actually.
Okay, yeah.
I'm going to add more belt buckles to my wardrobe.
Yeah, I would recommend. And
check out, what do you got going there today, Jake?
Well,
what's your belt
today
buckle?
We got a little cowboy here riding.
Hey, you put
horse,
it on the right so way. That's
yeah.
Awesome.
So, you know, I was thinking, you know, resolutions are about improving, and I thought maybe you could show up on time for a change.
I thought we were talking about our own resolutions. Yeah. Do you not?
Yeah,
you don't have one?
Flashback to when the show started 20 minutes late last time.
And you were still back there fixing your hair.
Right, yep.
Yeah.
So I have a resolution, and my resolution for 2020 is to actually make it through the whole Miles Barkham Hen House album.
Good luck.
So what else has been going on in Minot? Well, now the bars can stay open till 2 a.m. Yeah. Giving the saying that nothing good happens after midnight one more hour to work its magic. So it's been reported that the parking garages are now operating at a profit. A slight profit, but they are operating at a profit. And now they're scheduled to actually be paid off in 150 years. And that is only 60 years after they have to be tore down. In more local news, the Minot City Council has requested that the council building has a security upgrade. I also would request that if I had voted to double my own pay. So a lot of crazy things have been happening around the city, but also statewide. Williams County law enforcement recently accidentally let one of their prisoners go. Now, the prisoner, I don't know what he originally stole that landed him in the prison for burglary, but
meth,
he sure
meth,
is.
Meth, I think.
Yeah. All right. But he sure as hell stored the dignity of the Williams County law enforcement on his way out. Also in Williams County, like seriously, what the hell's going on over there anyways? The county commission recently denied a permit for radioactive landfill. And so if there is a city in North Dakota that needs a radioactive landfill that could lead to accidental superheroes, it's Williston. Also, the Little People Advocacy Group recently made their way to Dickinson. And they were asking that the high school change its mascot from the Midgets. Well, we know that that's a tall order. But in the end, they're hoping that there will be some uplifting results for everyone. Yes. I know, that was low-hanging fruit.
Ooh.
And so was that.
Are you done?
I'm done.
Okay.
I'm moving
Thank
on.
You. That was plenty.
Did you know that there was a man in Grand Forks who was arrested for breaking into the University of North Dakota's one of their sororities? Yeah. So it turns out, after an extensive search of the top drawers, local law enforcement was not able to prove that he was stealing anything.
They didn't sniff anything out?
It turns out, actually, that the guy was going in and recording the girls while they slept. Yeah. Creepy, right? In other news, Goodnight Minot has an opening for a new cameraman.
Cameron! Oh, come on, man. Come on. Ask someone out for a date. Come on, man.
And the new royal family of North Dakota, Carson Wentz. We all know how I feel about that. Carson Wentz and his wife, Madison, are expecting a baby. Yeah.
Yeah, and for some reason that made the news. Like.
Right. I didn't know.
That was literally on the news station. Their Instagram post was...
The Hen House album's been available for months.
Right, and somehow, they're talking about Carson Wentz.
And somehow Carson Wentz steals the headlines from you.
I should have done another ad for that.
So, Carson Wentz and his wife are having a child, and apparently we're celebrating procreation, but it turns out that Mrs. Wentz is the only person in the family who will be able to deliver in February.
Dude, do you think that you could handle a season in the NFL without getting injured, Jake?
Well, I think that if I was playing in the NFL, I would probably make it through the full season, and I would at least, you know, probably win a Super Bowl or something.
Yeah, that's what, are you serious? That's how big his head is. He seriously thinks that. He can't even run a mile.
You know,
You'd make it through half a quarter.
Have I ever told you about the time when I was the kicker for Jim Hill Middle School's 7th grade football team?
I think you did, actually.
Yeah. I mean, we had an onside kick. We almost recovered. And
I thought you just went for two every time.
Well, you know. So actually, I'm going to tell the story now that since I'm here and I got the mic. But so the coach tells me, says, let's go for the onside kick. And I kick it, and it bounces off one of their people. And some penalty of some sort that somebody else can explain happened. But we had to kick it again. And so we line up, and he's like, all right, they already knew we were doing the onside, so just kick it. So I line up, and I, you know, do my kick, and I send it, I don't know, 400 yards or whatever, long ways. And the guy from Ramsey catches the football like he's supposed to. And I'm standing there, you know, at the end, and he's running down the field, and he blows past some people, blows past a few more, and pretty soon I'm like, oh, it's just me and this guy. So I'm like, all right, I got this guy. So I go running at him, and we run into each other, and I'm flat on the ground, and he's heading down the field. And I'm like, damn it. And he trips and falls about 12 yards later, crediting me with my first tackle of the season. So. Thank you.
You know what? I was wrong. You can't handle a full right. season. Yeah, no, you're good. No ankle injuries.
Right.
You're solid.
I'm one for one on tackles. And finally, Baby Yoda from Star Wars The Mandalorian has...
He's so cute.
Well, he's taken the internet by storm, which is good news, actually, because for 40-year-old men still living in their mom's basement, now they have a baby they can post pictures of on Facebook. We've got a great show for you guys tonight. Our first guest is Ryan Wagner, who recently set the world record for the Mount Everest male camp run. I can't... Yeah. And also, we're talking about Mount Everest, the mountain. So in case some of you don't know, like, that's pretty big. So I can't even run across the living room to get another old Milwaukee without being a little bit short of breath.
What about Cheetos? Can you run for Cheetos?
Well, you keep those on the couch. The beer's got to stay cold. The chips stay with you. It's like the Summer of George from Seinfeld, you know? Speaking of inspiring, we'll also be joined by Minot's own Sarah Madalyn, whose Yes. Her commitment to education has landed her as North Dakota's Teacher of the Year. But first, we're going to say hello to Wild Hands, who's filling in as our house band tonight. We're excited to have them here. And now, I want to tell you that, you know, we don't get a lot of time to be all together to practice. And so earlier today, we were running through some of this, and I got to tell you, 6 hours ago, Nick was the worst rim shot player I've ever met. So
I seriously didn't know how to do this.
Yeah,
he's so awesome.
It was so bad. But I want to give Nick a chance, you know, for a couple of these rim shots, show you guys what he's learned. So, have you? Yeah. Have you heard of about the two peanuts? Yeah, so two peanuts are walking down the road and one was assaulted. All right.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Did you guys hear the one about the airplane? Ah, never mind, it's over your head. All right, okay, well how about this one? Okay, so, why did the Norwegian Navy have barcodes on their ships? So they could scan the Navy. Yeah. There you go. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, Nick.
He's a fast learner.
Yep. We are so excited. Wild Dance, thank you for being here. Thanks for being the house band. Take it away.
Oh, shucks. This is a real-life North Dakota song. It's a sing-along, so help us out if you know it. Someday, someday, someday I'll be coming back to you. Someday, someday, someday I'll be coming back to you. That's it. Someday, someday, someday I'll be coming back to you. I'll be coming back to you. Someday, 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 someday I'll be coming back to you. I'm your boomerang. I'm your boomerang. I'm your boomerang. I'm your boomerang now. You say I'm just a kid. You know I love to admit. 20-something years sitting on the shelf. Places I have been, places I would like to see next year. And these are just little memories, just another anniversary.
Down.
those heartaches keep you up. Don't let it get to your head too quick. Let's not forget this isn't our first time. Someday, someday, someday I'll be coming back to you. Someday, someday, someday I'll be coming back to you. Someday, someday, someday I'll be coming back to you. I'll be coming back to you. Someday, 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 someday I'll be coming back to you. I'm your boomerang, I'm your boomerang.
That was pretty cool, guys. There's just one thing. You know, Miles has drugged me to a few of your shows, and, well, I've noticed that Wild Hands is not very wild. Have you ever considered maybe changing your name to Civilized Hands? Compared to Miles, I mean, you guys are some real gentlemen, so thanks for being here. Our first guest has a story that'll blow your mind. Ryan Wagner, who lives in Makoti, North Dakota, holds the world record for the running the Everest Mail Run. That's right, folks. This guy, along with two teammates, ran a 400-mile marathon from the Mount Everest base camp to the city of Kathmandu. And he shattered the world record doing it. Ladies and gentlemen, brought to you by the Starving Rooster, please welcome to Goodnight Minot, Mr. Ryan Wagner. Ryan, it appears you have some fans out in the audience here.
Well, thank you.
And I got to tell you, you know, the first two guests we had on the last episode, we had these mugs for them as well. And I made sure when at the end of the interview, I said, please take this mug with you when you leave. And they left, and then I found them in the green room. So when I got here today, I just grabbed them off the shelf stand, and I brought it out here for you.
That worked for me.
But we are so excited you could be on the show. I mean, it's just thrilled to hear your story.
Well, so, thanks for having me. I'm glad that's not Old Milwaukee in there. The first time I drank, it was Old Milwaukee, and that's the last time I ever drank it.
You mean this guy right here?
No thanks.
All right, well, cheers, man.
That's all yours.
I thought maybe to start, you could tell us, what exactly is the Mount Everest Mail Run?
Well, it's crazy, I guess, for starters. it was originally, they sent mail to Kathmandu for the climbers that would climb Everest, and somebody would have to bring it up there, so that's what somebody did. They ran the mail up to the climbers at Everest Base Camp.
So what you're saying is it's exactly as simple as the title suggests.
Exactly, yep.
So I'm assuming that you were probably in a little better shape then than you are now, but...
yes, the holidays.
Yeah. So for a race like that, what's the prep look like?
Just run as much as you can, I guess.
And, yeah. Just
stay away from this guy.
Yeah, the old, the running part, right?
Yeah. Just unfortunately, you do have to run in order to do stuff like this, and That's kind of the downside, but well, at least it gets me away from my kids. I have five kids, so
right.
That's why I run these long things, to get away from them.
It's a good thing that this is recorded, so I can hear you say that later.
That's true love, right there.
You'll be like, what are we doing for Father's Day? And they'll be like, here's this thing. Maybe
you should
go for a run.
I'm trying to find something longer. But
right. Yep. So, you know, speaking of running, how did you get here tonight?
Yeah, it's too cold to run,
okay,
man.
So what you're saying is you can set a world record for a 400-mile race, but you can't run 44 miles from Makoti to be in our show tonight. So I know from visiting with you that you got a large family, and you mentioned that. How supportive has your family been throughout this, throughout your career and doing the racing?
Oh, unbelievable. My wife is just, well, I probably would quit a lot of my races, but she wouldn't let me, you know?
I remember you saying something like that. And I also remember you mentioning something a little bit about a black panel van type.
Yes.
Kind of cheerleading?
Yeah. We have a large conversion van, a 9-passenger van, has a big 32-inch TV in it, DVD player, super comfortable, right? It's really comfortable.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I got it.
The back seat folds down into a bed, and one race I was doing south of Fargo, and it was getting towards the dark, and we started early, so it must have been probably 40, 50 miles into the race. And I come up over this little hill, and I see the big black van, and I'm super excited. I finally get some food, some Gatorade.
Yep.
Come running up about a half a mile, I could see it, just waiting for my kids to jump out and, you know, kind of join me the last little bit in. And half a mile, quarter of a mile, still nobody. I'm like, what the heck is going on here? Get even closer. All of a sudden, I can hear Finding Nemo playing in the conversion van, right? So I get up to the windows. I'm looking in the windows, and here my wife and kids are all crashed out in the back.
Oh no!
I can see Finding Nemo playing. I pounded on the van, and they didn't wake up. So I just had to continue on.
So do you think any of your kids are gonna follow in your footsteps, literally?
I don't know. I hope so, but if they don't, I guess that's cool too.
Right. So when you go on these runs for hundreds of miles, literally, what kind of gear and food does a guy bring with him?
A lot of the races have food. So they have like quesadillas and
big fans, yeah.
For sure. Yeah. In the morning they'll have pancakes.
So there's one thing that can get me through a run, it's a quesadilla.
There you go. Yeah. Run to the next aid station, right, that's what'll keep you going. And then you pack your own, food. So
yeah.
And then you have a vest that holds all your gear and water. So yeah,
So while you're out there running, literally tracking through the wilderness here, you must have seen a few crazy things.
Oh yeah, for sure. I saw garage sales and animals and all sorts of crazy stuff, yeah. After 65 hours of, you know, not really sleeping, I have a tendency to hallucinate from time to time. Yeah. So.
And it doesn't have to do anything with the food you make for yourself on the run?
Perhaps.
So while you're out there, have you ever been lost, or have you been, you know, found to not be that prepared for the race?
Yes, I have. I have been lost for 8 hours. Yeah, and they had to send a crew out to find me. Yeah,
I got kind of
out of it a little bit. Yeah, I don't think I ate or drank as much as I should have, and just kind of was on the trail and just decided to hang a left.
Like, left here seems good.
Yeah, yep. I don't know. Maybe I saw a sign that said, hang a left. I don't know.
Yep. So I got to imagine a little bit that, you know, when they're going to send some people out on a 400-mile race, that maybe they tack them with a GPS or something. Did you have any experience with that when you were lost?
Yeah, I was supposed to download something onto my phone. And, of course, my wife said, you better do it. And
right.
Of course, I didn't listen.
Yeah.
And so now I have a tendency to listen to her a little bit more anyways.
Yeah, well, that's good. Yeah. So, yeah, I got to imagine that on a 400-mile race, you know, we talk about the, you know, 5Ks and things like that, and people are sprinting their way to the finish.
What's the last little bit of the race look like when you're going 400 miles?
Oh, it's awesome. Because you know you're done. that's probably the best part, the last little bit, because you know that you're done.
Yeah.
And that's it.
So I know that you wanted to give a couple shout outs while you're up here tonight, talk a little bit about End Racing, and I think it was Destin
that you wanted to give a shout out to.
Yeah, Faces the Thunder, that's a crew that helped me with lots of prayers and, you know, just support.
Of course, my wife, Whitefish Woman.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And my family, of course. Jeez, now you got me all emotional.
I know, I'm sorry. That's good. So, you know, you're tackling a lot of things with running, you're really making a difference, but what impact is it that you hope to have on, you know, racing, whether it be in North Dakota or your families or the people around you?
Just to motivate people, just to get out there. You know, I started with a mile, and my wife can tell you that, you know, that first mile was tough.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah, just persevere through it and, you know, don't be fearful. That's what would have held me back from this 400-mile race. Like, I didn't know if I could do it, but don't be fearful of that, because you don't know if you don't try.
Yeah. Well, definitely, I think Ryan's a testament of some perseverance and hard work here. Let's hear a little bit for Ryan. I know you have a pretty remarkable story. And I would also like to share a story with you. And so, you know, over the holiday season and things like or maybe just year round, where dads read their kids, you know, stories and they go to bed and maybe they're motivated. I don't know, but it's just kind of an endearing moment. Well, we're gonna test Ryan's athleticism a little bit during this next story. And I've got a story that's based around the night before Christmas that has to do with Minot. And so what I thought is, I would read the story, and for endearing, you could hold me in your arms up here. So we're gonna go ahead and do that, but if you could also wear this hat, that'd be great. So,
all right.
I wasn't kidding about the holding up here, because we wanna see just how athletic you are.
Over here?
Yeah, well, I could sit on your lap here. I was thinking you could hold me like wedding style. Right? What do you think, guys?
Know,
can
man.
You do it? All right.
This is gonna be a long story.
Yep. All right. So, 'twas the night before Christmas, and all through the city, the council was begging for everyone's pity. The parking garages were decorated with care in hopes that people soon would park there. Mayor Sitma was nestled all snug in his bed while visions of flood protection danced in his head. And I in my beanie and Miles in his cap were exchanging the chat by way of the snap. When out in the street there arose such a clutter, I rushed to the window to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash and saw drunk people knocking over the trash. The moon on the breast of new-fallen snow gave luster strewn objects there down below. When what to my wandering eyes did appear but the mall Santa and seven empty beers. He pulled out his cell phone and dialed so fierce, and he yelled obscenities that jolly Saint Nick was holding the button and was yelling at Siri, and I know what he said, he yelled it so clearly. Now Uber, now Lyft, now Minot Taxi, on Premier, on Central, on Passerby Hippie. To the top of the hill, to the landing off sail, and dash away, so I can get some ale. Let's give it up for Ryan, everybody.
He did it! He did it! He held him the whole time! Nice! Wow!
Ryan Wagner, everybody, let's hear it for Ryan. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Here's your mug. Yeah. Take it home with you.
Do I get the hat too?
Yeah, well, if you need it, you can have it. Let's give it up for Ryan. One of the great joys this holiday is seeing the looks on the faces of your friends and loved ones as they open gifts. Here at Goodnight Minot, we recently had our own little gift exchange, and, well, we felt compelled to document it after our lawyer's recommendation. But that aside, it was quite the evening. And while I wouldn't call any of them my friends, much less loved ones, they're still a very big part of, you know, the unfortunate parts of the whole deal. But I present to you the Goodnight Minot Gift Giving Fiesta.
I know, but they're super expensive.
God, here
we
go. If I have to hear that skydiving story,
hey.
I'm gonna flip. Hey, Jonah.
Oh, hey, Jonah. Dude, you guys, you know what I was thinking we should do for Christmas this year?
What?
We should go in on a skydiving trip together.
No.
Don't you?
No.
You haven't lived if you haven't jumped out of an airplane. What are you afraid of?
I'm not afraid.
We gotta do this.
I am not afraid.
Miles will do it with me.
You know what I'm afraid
Miles,
of?
Miles loves my skydiving story.
Nobody loves that skydiving story.
Fine. Plan B. Let's all pitch in together and throw Jacob Thrapkill out of an airplane.
Yes.
Hard I'm on board with that.
Yeah, but do you think his big head will fit off the cargo door?
No, I mean, his ego is going to keep him floating for a long time, but it keeps him out of our hair for a little while.
He might actually
Thrapkill!
Hey, guys. How are you?
Welcome to the party.
And please, we're all friends here. Call me Jake. Mr. Thrapkill lives in the office.
Here you go.
This is real leather, so if you could make sure it gets on a wood hanger, that'd be great. And then take care of the beamer. Hey, I'm here now. Let's get this party started.
Party!
After you, Terry girl. Thank you. Some of us are gentlemen.
Yeah, no kidding, right?
That's good.
Thank you.
To see you. Yeah.
I am so excited to give you guys these gifts. I just know you're gonna love them.
Whoa. Before we get to that, we'd like to give you our gift.
Like a gift? As in singular?
Yeah,
we thought we'd all pitch in and get you something special.
Oh, is this like a hint that you guys all need a raise or something? You can't afford to buy Christmas gifts?
First of all, you can't give anybody here a raise, and second of all, we just wanted to do something really nice for you.
Well, I thought I would get you each something individually so that, you know, that'd be better than if you all had to share something.
Okay.
Jonah, I got you this since you're always wanting to tell me what to do. Now you can practice at home.
Well, yeah, man, somebody's got to program the bot. Oh, you, it's a picture of you.
Yeah.
That's you got me a picture of you, Jake. Jake fucking Thrapkill.
Yeah. And Terry, I love your pre-show. Sometimes I feel like you're upstaging me a bit, and this is to remind you of whose show it actually is.
Oh, okay. Oh, it's another picture of you.
God, look at my teeth are just perfect in that one.
I guess it's better than the nudes you've been sending me. Thank you.
You're welcome. And Adam, you are so great at capturing my good side, and I just want to remind you of what the focus of the show is.
Who left this?
Jake.
Um, thank you, I guess? I mean, that's another picture of Jake.
Yes, you're welcome. I knew you'd love it.
Whatever, man.
Yeah. And Shenan, this is from my private collection.
Oh my, it's so big. I'm sure I'll find it somewhere to put it.
I was thinking you could put that one right above that fireplace you have.
Oh, yeah, maybe I can take one of the Walter Peels down and... yeah? Is that what you would like?
Yeah, that old cowboy just throws paint at canvas anyways. That's a masterpiece. Yeah, Miles, I got something for you too. Just let me see here. So this is so you can keep me with you at your side all the time. You'll always have something to remember I'm with you.
Oh, thank you so much, Jake. Oh,
yep. That's so awesome. All right, that's enough. Oh, yeah, hey. I would like a old-fashioned with angle bitters, bourbon, and two cherries. You think you can handle that, sport?
Jake, I'm Cameron, the intern. I've been here since the first show.
Really?
Yeah,
I ran camera and I've been helping with the monologue jokes.
Oh, well, in that case, I got something for you too here. Just let me see what I can get. Oh, here you go. You're just a couple punches away from a free pizza buffet on me.
Jake, this is expired.
Okay, Kevin, it's Mr. Thrill Kill to you. Thanks. If you could grab that drink still, that'd be awesome. Christ.
Ho, 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 mother.
Holy shit. Vodka Mike, is that you?
Never heard of him. It's the weekend, playboy. Vodka Santa in the heezy.
There you go, Kevin.
Thanks for having this party at a bar I'm still allowed in.
Dude, where the f*** have you been?
I don't know. The mall? Jail? Your mom's house?
What?
What's in the bag, Vodka Santa?
It is time to ignite the night.
Oh my god.
Are those fireball candy canes?
They are fireball candy canes.
How come this one's half full?
Well, that reminds me, I got a little something extra for you.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, nice. It's in here. Let me just look around in there a little bit.
Vodka Mike, I told you, you're not allowed in here anymore. You gotta go.
Excuse me? You told Vodka Mike that? You didn't tell Vodka Santa that. Potato, potato, speaking of potatoes, holy shit. Merry Christmas.
Oh, potato.
Oh, Merry f***ing Christmas, Happy New Year, and good night, my house.
Party's over, boys and girls.
One more shot.
Here we go.
Here you go, intern.
None for Jenna. No, you're out, buddy.
What?
All right, you guys. Here's your check for the evening.
Oh, no. Let me get it. I'll take care of this one.
He likes to think he's the boss. Might as well start paying like one.
It's my show. I think I can take care of this for you guys here. See, I got a little something here. And this one's signed. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Good man.
Dude, why do you always gotta make me look like an ass on those things? Jeez. Before we bring on our next guest, we're gonna have another tasty tune from Wild Hands.
Thank you.
This love is like a dream. It keeps growing just like a weed. A home and a song to sing. It keeps growing just like a weed. A sign that you left upon the shelf. A branch from your heart and mine. Just don't lose love on the vine. But love is blind, I see. This love is growing.
Gave me a little bit time to calm down about the Christmas skit, because I just don't understand when I give all of you individual thoughtful gifts, you know, I get nothing in return.
We gave you a gift and you just like brushed it off to the side, and then when
must
we
have
were
been small.
Well, Tanya gave me a call after we got back and she said that Tanya, you left your gift there. So I got it back and I waited till today to give it to you. I hope you like it. I mean, we all spent a lot of time picking it out and talked about it a lot, so. All
right, well.
Let's see.
Well, thank you for doing that, Miles.
Yeah, we love you, Jake. That's why we do it.
All right.
It's Christmas.
And
well, it's past Christmas.
We got a belt buckle. The J.
Hold it where it goes. Yeah, there we go. Everyone check it out. Look real close. Yeah.
As pictured on Goodnight Minot at episode 3. Geez, you guys really like me, but in all seriousness, folks, my Goodnight Minot team is more than that. They're family, and I wouldn't be here without them, and somebody didn't write this line for me. I love you guys. And now,
we're going to get to introducing our second guest. Our next guest, presented by Minot State University, is the North Dakota Teacher of the Year for 2020. She's a reading and math interventionist at Minot Sunnyside Elementary School, working with students who struggle with reading and arithmetic. She also runs several programs to encourage reading, leadership development, and physical fitness. Please welcome to the Goodnight Minot stage, North Dakota Teacher of the Year, Miss Sarah Madalin. Just not late for dinner, right? Sarah, you look fabulous. Thanks for being on the show.
Thank you.
And I'm glad you came out with that shot at me because, as many of you know, Sarah was supposed to be on our first episode of Goodnight Minot. And we even put her in the radio ad. And then she canceled on us. So what's up with that?
Actually was on the Ellen show.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So.
No, Bison game, kind of.
Right, yeah,
sorry.
They were that Carson one. Sandy is used bullshit again. All right. So.
You're a hockey boy, right?
Well, yeah.
He's a UND hockey boy.
There's the Superior College in North Dakota, and then there's NDSU and the rest. So, Nick, you're getting the hang of it. I like it. So one might say that you were a little bit tardy to Goodnight Minot, so we've got this pink slip for you. So Sarah,
well deserved.
Yeah, well, I agree. So Sarah, tell us a little bit about how you ended up in education.
You know, I'm just really fortunate to be in a family that really values education and lifelong learning. I have a lot of family members who... Is it not on?
Oh, it's really quiet.
On.
Yeah, so okay. Use your teacher voice.
Use my teacher voice. so I have some family members that were in education, and I just followed that path and love what I do. It's the best job.
Mm-hmm. So you follow the path.
Right?
Yep. And now you're North Dakota's Teacher of the Year for 2020. What responsibilities come with, you know, bearing that title?
Being on Goodnight Minot.
Yep, that's good. Well, it's got to be one of the top things,
yeah,
for sure.
For sure. Really, just I've said over and over, I'm definitely not the best teacher in North Dakota by any means, but. I guess my role really is just to be an advocate. I'm one of the great teachers. No, I'm not one of the great. I'm one of the many teachers. I didn't mean that.
Whoa, all right.
Shoot, do you have an editing? I'm one of the many teachers in North Dakota
Pause
who are just working really hard for kids. And just I guess my role now is to be an advocate for the profession and mostly for kids. And I get to go to Google in February.
That's exciting.
And I get to do some fun traveling things. And. Mm-hmm. And hopefully I can come back and just really represent North Dakota and Minot and all the educators. Yeah. I'm not the best. I'm not great. I got to cut that.
What, you know, you said something about being the North Dakota Teacher of the Year as it relates to other teachers. What message would you have for them, for the other teachers?
Oh, I think for me, you know, when I first started, I just was kind of going through the motions and as it went on, I really started realizing that, I ended up at Sunnyside, which is a high poverty school, and these kids are just like, they need you, and they need so much more than the math and the reading. And so really that whole relationship thing and helping kids really believe in who they are and achieve their dreams, I guess so much more than like teaching the curriculum and doing all the things the district wants us to do. Better not tell the district that.
Yes, it's a good thing this isn't recorded.
Yeah, you know, I always say that we really need to reach the heart before we can teach the mind. And that's what I believe.
The two biggest clips from tonight will be Ryan trashing on his family and you on the district. Right? I'm just kidding. But, you know, I know that you want to be an advocate for education across the state. What other things do you hope to accomplish as your year of being the North Dakota Teacher of the Year?
You know, really, North Dakota does have one of the best education systems in the nation. And so really, I just want to bring that to light a little bit. I really want North Dakota to be known a little bit more throughout the nation because we should be recognized as one of the best. We do a lot of great things here in North Dakota for education, and I really hope that I can just take that message out into the rest of the nation. And
yeah, absolutely. I mean, fifth grade was the best 3 years of Miles' life. So. But this doesn't come alone. So what's your support system look like?
My support system?
Yeah.
What is right in the...
Oh, this one?
That's
right
one
here.
Of my support system.
Well, we finally have something in common, yeah.
You know, it's funny, I was just thinking about how there's so much talk about mental health and taking care of your mental health, and educators really, we take care of kids so much and make sure that we take care of ourselves. And I was thinking about it over break, that for me, really, taking care of myself really is taking care of the kids. It just really, it really fills me up. And, you know, of course I have a great family they have to hear a lot of the sad stories that I bring home, and they have to pretend to laugh like the audience is.
Not
some
at
of
my
the
jokes,
funny
though.
Stories that yeah. I bring home.
Now he gets the hang of the rimshot deal. So with being the North Dakota Teacher of the Year, you get some perks, and obviously you're taking advantage of them, hopefully, right? And I mean, you're on Goodnight Minot, so that's got to be a perk, but...
Thank you, Ellen.
What other opportunities have come to you from since you've been named North Dakota's Teacher of the Year?
Well, like I said, I get to go to Google in February. I'm excited about that. And I get to go to Washington, D.C. for about 5 days in May. Mm-hmm. In the summer, I get to go to space camp. So, some pretty cool perks that go along with it.
Yeah, I remember you saying something about how you're going to star in the next Top Gun or something. What was that about?
Well, gosh, it was over a year ago. The Chamber of Commerce contacted me. And they wanted to do a hometown hero flight with the Thunderbirds when they were in town for,
excellent.
So I'm definitely don't consider myself a hometown hero, but I wasn't going to say no to that.
Right.
And so I immediately said yes, had to go through some hoops, and you know, ended up flying with the Thunderbirds.
Yeah. So what's the selection process look like if you're going to be a hometown hero? Because, you know, do you put an application in?
Yeah, no application. Yeah. When they called, I was so excited. I was just thrilled. And then when I got out to the base, and by the way, any military here, you guys are the true heroes of this area. Not for sure. So when I got to the base and we were going through some training and there was some media there and... somebody from the media said, so, you know, how did you get to do this? And one of the other military people stepped in and said, well, actually, she was our third choice. Okay. And I didn't know that. I was like, what? And then they said, well, we wanted to have Josh Duhamel as our first choice, but he's already flown with the Blue Angels, and it really is once in a lifetime.
Okay.
And they tried to get Carson Wentz, but they couldn't get him out of training. So yeah, after they told me that, I said, yeah, you go ahead and put that story in the news and tell why I was a third
right,
choice.
Right, so you're only...
Third choice is good.
You're only third to Josh Duhamel and Carson Wentz, so that's pretty spectacular. Yeah, definitely.
I mean, there's no question, I will never do anything that cool again. My kids...
Well, you're on this show, so...
I mean, yeah. my students, like, it rose to a whole new level when I've shown them the videos of hitting 9 Gs, and yep. It's really awesome.
That's awesome.
A great opportunity.
So when it's all said and done and you've had your education career and it comes to a wrap, what do you want your legacy to be? And maybe while you think about that, do any of you guys from Civilized Hands or Miles, you want to share, you know, what you want your legacy to be? Now they're looking good. Back to you. Yeah.
Well, right now, really, a couple of things I'm most proud of. One of the things I'm most proud of at school, really, is I started a Girl Power program. And woo! Yeah, I got some Girl Power. Don't worry, guys. We make it very clear to the boys in school that it doesn't mean we're better than boys. It means we're equal to boys. But really, I've really worked at empowering these girls, and really the goal is just to make themselves better and to make the lives of other people better. And it's just really grown. And sometimes the littlest people can make the biggest impact, and that's the case in the Girl Power program. The girls have raised, last year they raised over $5,000, and we paid for 8 girls to go to school in Haiti.
Wow.
And this year we're on track. We're just a little bit shy of that. And it's just really cool and we FaceTime with our friends in Haiti. And so for these young girls to see the impact that they're making at a young age, like we went to the legislature and the girls were able to see that 20% of our legislature are females, and really to just empower these girls that, their voices make a difference. And so that's, again, not that I think girls are better than boys, but...
Well, you basically said it, but whatever.
All right, it's time for a pop quiz. We've got Teacher of the Year here.
Miles,
and,
what the hell are you doing right now?
We're putting this to the test. Jake, you're the best and smartest guy I know. I want to help show the world that you're smarter than elementary school children, which I'm pretty sure you are. And the North Dakota Teacher of the Year, but I need a tie because I need to be the host of this thing. So here, give me your tie and your jacket.
I'm not going to give you my tie.
Give me your tie and your jacket.
No. That's right. Why?
Come on.
Are you?
Let's go.
This. Okay. I always care with me, so you just throw that on, maybe. We'll see how...
Are you saying that I don't have to hold
Sarah,
Jake while he reads it? Right.
You have to carry Jake through this quiz, is what you need to do.
Sorry, I have to say that I don't know any about what this is going on, so
okay.
It's extremely uncomfortable.
All right, here it is, pop quiz. Sarah, you're first. Which country is both an island and a continent? Country,
well, I'd like
continent.
To talk, if you could, I always say that if kids can find it on Google, we shouldn't be teaching them that. No, right. Hold on, I always teach them
that's
this song.
That's what your teacher of the
North
year,
America,
you say
South
that?
South
yeah. Oh my God.
North America, South America, Europe, Asia too, Africa, Australia.
Hey! She got it, she got it, that's the answer. One for Sarah. Jake, what are the first 17 digits of pi?
I believe that would be 3.14696969. Go to hell.
That's a big fat zero for Jake on that one. Sarah 1, Jake 0. Sarah, how many days does it take the Earth to travel around the sun?
365.
Nice. That's 2.
Okay.
2 to nothing, Jake.
All right.
Jake. What is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow?
Well, Miles, I'm going to have... Can I phone a friend on that?
It's an African swallow, I'll tell you that much.
Okay. Anybody from Wild Hands want to help me out with that?
About 50.
Yeah. About 2. About 52, I think we're at.
No. Okay, that's 0 for Jake, 2 for Sarah. Sarah, what are the first 10 amendments to the Constitution called? Like, there's 10 of them. What are they called as a whole?
The Bill of Rights.
Boom! Booyah! That's 3.
Okay. Yeah.
That's 3 to nothing, Jake. Nothing!
Can this one be worth 3 points?
Wait, is there money involved in this? Is he going to have to pay up?
There is a prize. There's
always
a prize.
A prize.
Yes.
hopefully
so
not mine.
We can make this one worth two. How about that, Jake?
Okay.
All right. Who was the 13th president?
Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Millard Fillmore.
Oh! He got it.
Oh, hey!
That's it. That's it.
I told him that in the back room.
Right.
So that's three to a cheater's two now. All right, yep. Here we go. Sarah, who wrote the Little House on the Prairie books?
Have you read, anybody in the audience read Little House?
No,
That was my mom's favorite TV show. She's
and it's her birthday.
It
was actually it wrong.
And it's okay.
And I already used our phone a friend. So.
Laura Ingalls Wilder.
Yep. Jake, what is philematology?
I believe that would be the study of kissing.
Ooh, yes. So, how did you know that?
Well, I, you know, story for another show.
Okay. Well, when I'm all grown up, I want to hear it. Well, that was the last question. So, Jake, you're the biggest loser on this one. That's a show too, right? All right.
All right. Well,
4-2. That was well played. Well played.
Let's hear it for Sarah Minot. Tell us, did she win anything?
So, Sarah, for winning our pop quiz, we'd like to give you and your students a complimentary pizza party from Papa John's. So, have a great time with that, and say hi to your students from Goodnight Minot.
Thank you.
Let's give it up for Sarah Madalyn, everybody. Thank you. Hey, the mug. Folks, that means that our show is coming to an end. But it wouldn't be right if we didn't close with another segment. So back by popular demand, if businesses had Tinder profiles.
Is that where you learned about the study of kissing? Was from Tinder?
Well, you know, if you saw my profile, even you would swipe right.
I'm on the other one.
So here we are. If businesses had Tinder. Coming up first on the list tonight, Atypical Brewery and Barrel Works. Just because you sponsor the show doesn't keep you safe. First date ideas. I dump out all your PBR while wearing only a flannel. Then you compliment my beard as we listen to Bon Iver. Things get feisty on my futon. I suggest using beard oil as lube. You're totally into it. But when you ask why three-legged emotional support dog has to watch, which offends me, so I call you a lift home and then sour beer drink myself into a coma.
I'd date that.
A1, Evan's Septic Service. Yes, the A does stand for anal. I like it a little messy. On the rocks. No, seriously, I'm on the rock. Going to prison in March, so. Thanks, Andy. So, not looking for anything serious. Herbology. Barely legal, but ready to party. Willing to oil you up and calm you down. Care more about CBDs than STDs. Shots Crossroads. I'm banking on your standards being lower than mine. Dakota Square Mall. Damn it, Mike. Santa's been gone for 3 days, and we have no idea who that guy is. Ebenezer's. Speaking of Miles, I've been with enough failed musicians to appreciate a steady hand. I've dated half the guys in Goodnight Minot band, so small shoes to fill. Hibachi Grill and Buffet allows you to show... Who was that? That was rude. Allows you to show off your cultural sensitivity. Doesn't mind giving it to you raw. Woo! Options for all you can eat. And I mean all you can eat. The North Dakota State Fair. Not afraid of being strapped down and spun around. Famous for our footlongs and messy tacos. You weren't impressed last time, but yet it's 2 a.m. and here you are. Trinity Hospital. Imagine, we go out, I feed you drugs. Then we hook up, you stay the night, and it was okay. 3 months later, I double bill you for the experience. Well, folks, that's our show. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here tonight. If you have your ticket, you can bring it to the Starving Rooster, get 15% off. Our art here tonight came from none other than the famous Walter Peel. And we'd like to thank our guests tonight and the Wild Hands Band for being here. Wild Hands Band for being here. Thank you so much. I'm your host, Jake Grillkill, and good night, Maya.